I, Taban Dengai, do hereby swear by Almighty God, do hereby swear by Almighty God, that as the first Vice President, that as the first Vice President of the Republic...
With the disappearance of former First Vice President Riek Machar from office, SPLM-IO body nominates a new leader for the vacant position to be sworn in as the first Vice President of the Republic of South Sudan.
Honestly, discharge my duties and responsibilities in a consultative manner.
Having taken and swearing in as the first Vice President of the Republic, I've never struggled for this position or even dream of it. But the circumstances force us to fill a vacuum so that we save our nation.
First Vice President Taban Deng, after being sworn into office, is emotionally torn by the conditions of citizens still living in the IDP camps.
I will struggle to bring you out from the suffering you are in an IDP camp. You don't deserve to be there. You don't deserve to be displaced in your own country. I will work with all of you. And my first target is that you come out of the refugees of the IDP camp. You return to your home and help developing your country. Your Excellency, Mr. President, as I said, you are my commander-in-chief. The country cannot have two armies. I will move with you.
President Kiir reassures to respect the decision and the concern of the SPLM-IO, arguing his new first vice president to assist in the implementation of the peace agreement.
Comrade Taban Dengai was selected by the SPLM-IO to replace Dr. Riek Machar, whose whereabouts are not known to all of us. I have been appealing to him to come back to Juba so that we continue with the implementation of the agreement. Of course, this agreement cannot be personalized, that if X is away, the agreement will be shelved until when that person comes. That cannot happen. So, Comrade Taban, Zumla Batak, let us move forward. I want us really to see, where do people go wrong? Why is it that we are not stopping the war?
President Kiir assures his full commitment to ensure South Sudan's integrity and sovereignty is preserved.
Dr. Riek Machar has been calling for intervention of foreign forces, international or regional, so that they create a buffer zone. We will consider that force as an invading force. We are not against the international community.
It is in fulfillment of the agreement for the resolution of the conflict. There is one article which many of us always gloss over, and it is erroneous to gloss over that. And this is what justifies, by the way, the IO leadership from acting. The replacement shall be nominated by the top leadership body of South Sudan Armed Opposition, the IO, as at the signing of this agreement. Such a process of replacement shall not exceed 48 hours. And instead, they've been so patient, they did not act within the legal 48 hours, but they actually gave 2 weeks for Dr. Yak to appear. And president has been asking, ah, brother, you appear, and Yak cannot appear. I think if you have a number of goats and one is lost, you cannot continue to mourn for the lost goats. You have to go ahead with the remaining goats.
Dr. Yak Machar abandoned his office and SPLM IO leadership in Juba after what the government saw as an attempt on the life of the president in and around the presidential palace on the eve of South Sudan's independence.
With the whereabout of Dr. Yak Machar, the head, the former first vice president, still a mystery for the government and the SPLM in opposition. This step taken is to ensure that the vacuum that was seen as a setback for the implementation of the peace agreement in South Sudan is sealed. James Arusi, SSBC.